Hello friends, this is Dr. Sangeeta from Dental Pathshala, where we help you understand and learn dentistry better and easy way. And today we are going to be going over early childhood caries. Early childhood caries are the dental caries which occur in very young age in very young children. It may be due to prolonged and improper feeding habits, and most of the times it's the poor oral hygiene. So this video will talk about the definitions of the early childhood carie, classification of the early childhood carie, clinical features, and based on the clinical features we'll also discuss the classification and how to treat early childhood carie. So let's get started. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel and click on the bell icon. That way you get a notification as soon as I release a video lecture for you. Now coming to the definition of early childhood caries. Early childhood caries is defined as the presence of one or more decayed teeth, which can be cavitated lesion or any non-cavitated lesion, or the missing teeth. If any teeth is missing, it is due to the caries or any filled tooth surface which is present in any primary tooth. Now in a child whose age is less than the child who's younger than 71 months. Now coming to the another definition for early childhood caries, according to Davies in 1998, it is a complex disease. Now early childhood caries is a complex disease which involves the maxillary primary incisors, and this involves within a month after the eruption. So now after the eruption of teeth, within a month the child has got early childhood caries, and actually these caries spread rapidly and it involves one or more primary teeth. Now basically it is the maxillary primary incisor, but it can spread rapidly to involve other teeth, other primary teeth. Dental caries are caused by interaction between this dental caries. Actually, we have already studied, is caused by the bacteria which produces acid and the carbohydrate substrate, which is frequently the sucrose and the host susceptibility. Now these acidogenic bacteria, this species which is primarily pathogen for the early childhood caries, is Streptococcus mutans. So Streptococcus mutans is recognized to be the primary pathogen for the early childhood caries. So along with the S mutans, early childhood caries also report some significant association with S parasanguinis, and this is Streptococcus parasanguinis and Streptococcus salivarius, Lactobacillus casei, and Actinomyces viscus. So this is the A viscus. Now these all are the associated bacteria which are associated with S mutans and which are involved with the early childhood caries. Now, early childhood caries, the classification was given by Wien H in 1999, and this is a classification of early childhood caries which involves the common, the probable etiology and the range of the age which is affected, and the clinical features of the particular early childhood caries lesion, and it is classified into mild, moderate and the severe lesions. Now coming to the mild or we can say the type 1 early childhood caries. Now these type 1 mild caries are isolated lesions which are involved the molars and the incisors, and the cause of the mild lesion for early childhood caries is a combination of food, the cariogenic, semi-food and the poor oral hygiene. It is found commonly found in the 2 to 5 years of age. Coming to the second one is the moderate early childhood caries, which is our type 2, and it is the labiolingual caries lesions. The lesion are extend from labia to lingually, and this involve the maxillary incisor. It is involved, either the molar are involved or not involved. So the molars, with or without involvement of the molars, and the most common cause is the bottle feeding or at will breastfeeding, and also poor oral hygiene plays a role in causing the early childhood caries. Now, this occurs in after the eruption of the first tooth. This is about the moderate to severe early childhood caries or type 2. Now, coming to the type 3, which is our severe early childhood caries, it affects all the teeth. Now, all the teeth are involved in the severe, and especially the mandibular incisor. Now, mandibular incisors were not involved previously, but involved in the severe, and the cause is the diet, the cariogenic diet, and the poor oral hygiene. Now, this is a rapidly progressing condition. It progresses so rapidly and involves all the teeth. All the surfaces are involved, and this therefore, this progression, it is known as the acute or rampant caries. Now, coming to the classification, the clinical features can also be classified, and according to Harris and Gracia Godoy, we can classify the clinical features of early childhood caries. In 1999, they gave the classification, and according to the clinical pictures of stages of development, we can classify the stage 1, which is very mild, or the initial stage of early childhood caries according to clinical features. And there is appearance of chalky, opaque demineralization lesions. These lesions are present on the smooth surfaces, and between 10 to 20 months of age this is seen, and there is distinctive white line which is present in the mild stages, and these lesions are actually reversible at this stage because this is the early stage, so the lesions are reversible, but they are actually frequently unrecognized by the parents, so they are unable to recognize the lesion. Now, coming to the second stage, which is the mild stage or stage 2 according to clinical features, and the demineralization is shown in the gingival 1/3 of the tooth or moderate cavitation. Now, dentin gets involved with the rapid development, causes this enamel to collapse, and the dentin, exposed dentin, now appears soft and yellow, and the mild lesions are present in the child between 16 to 24 months of age, and the child explains or complains the sensitivity to any change in the temperature to the temperature changes. So this is about the mild, the stage 2 clinical features. Coming to the moderate lesions. Now, these moderate lesions are the stage 3, which are, there is multiple tooth involvement, multiple tooth surface is seen, the cavitation on the multiple tooth surfaces with the large deep lesions which are present. The large deep lesions are present on the maxillary incisors region, and this causes pulpal irritation. Now, the moderate lesions or stage 3 lesions are, the age which is affected is 20 to 36 months of age, and child gives a history of spontaneous pain and frequent causes of pulpal involvement. Now, coming to the stage 4, which is the severe clinical features. Now, clinically, there is widespread destruction of the tooth and partial to complete loss of the crown. So, crowns are also lost in the severe case, and these are characterized by the crown fractural or to the of the anterior maxilla due to enamelodentinal destruction. Now, there is the maxillary incisors are involved, and there is necrosis of maxillary incisor, and it occurs between 30 to 48 months of a child. In this severe case, the child experiences pain and discomfort. Now, in the severe case, the patient is in severe pain, the child is in severe pain, and the child is in discomfort. Very mild, it starts from 10 to 20 months. Mild is 16 to 24. 20 to 36 months is the moderate, and when it's extend to 30 to 48 months, it is severe. Now, very mild white lines are seen, and dentin is involved in the mild, and there is sensitivity. Moderate, multiple teeth are involved, and patient give history of pain. In the maxillary incisors are involved. Severe is the incisors are involved, and there is severe pain and discomfort patient complain of. Now, which tooth is the hit the hardest? Which tooth hits the hardest? Why the maxillary incisors? Why the primary first molars we are talking. Why these teeth are involved is due to early eruption of these tooth, and there is they are at the vulnerable position. Now canines and second primary molars are seldom due to their late eruption, but incisors are least involved because they protect the tongue, protect, and the saliva protects it from caries. So their involvement indicates improper use of pacifiers or rampant caries. Now, we should take the history, maternal history, and we should take the feeding history of the child to evaluate, to diagnose, and to treat. Coming to the treatment, if there is multiple teeth involvement, if so many teeth are involved, and if we are doing a quadrant treatment on a quadrant wise treatment, now in the two situations, we have two options. The first one is when we deal with the chief complaint. The first one is where the chief complaint is dealt first. Now, in the severe debilitating cases, when the child experiences pain, we should treat the complaint. And the second one is the minor treatment, which is started later on or afterwards. Now, the sequence of treatment should be a GIC or a composite filling, which is followed by an endodontic treatment, endodontic management, and finally the extraction or exodontia. If there is incipient or white spot lesions present, then it should be treated with a fluoride, topical fluoride application. I'll give you this link in the description below. Up in the eye button, we have already covered it. Or we apply the fissure sealants. Now, the carious lesion, if they are present in enamel and dentine, then we should provide the preventive resin restoration, GIC restoration, or we can treat with a composite restoration, and we can give a stainless steel crown in extensive. And if caries, if involved in the pulpal region, then pulpal therapy with a full coverage coronal restoration should be given, and sometimes exodontia with space management. Now we have to recall a patient, and after all the sequence of all the treatment, patient should be recalled in 3 months of time after the procedure is done, and during the first recall session, examination and radiograph should be done, and fluoride application should be given again, and patient should be given instructions with the oral hygiene and counseling if it is required. Now, we all know that prevention is always better than cure. So, where there is prevention, there is no need for cure. So, prevention is better than cure. Now, we should take some oral hygiene measures. So, before the tooth is erupted, actually, and we should advise the parents to massage the gums, and using some gauze piece or either with the help of ghee and with the index finger, and care should be taken to clean the dorsal surface of the tongue. Tongue should be cleaned, and this should be done 3 times a day. Now, after the tooth are erupted, parents should be instructed to use a toothbrush. And we should advise the parents to use a fluoridated toothpaste. And if it is after the eruption of teeth after 6 months. Now, also between ages from 18 to 24, the child is encouraged to use brush his own teeth under the supervision. Until the child reaches 7 years of age, the toothbrush should be supervised. And toothpaste up to 2 years, a rice grain size is recommended, and up to 5 years pea grain size. So this is about early childhood caries, and we were running too fast in today's video because it is only about the caries, and as we all know everything and most of the things about caries. So leave it in the comment below the next video topic you want to read, and if you feel that you have learned something new today, then go ahead and hit the comment box and the like button, because this helped me to help you skyrocket your career and knowledge while you stay at home with your family.